so they don't have to, if there's a fall risk, they can they get it easily? Is there a nightlight in the house for use? Doorways, stepways, walkways, are they clear? And especially if the steps are used frequently, do they have some non-skid strips on them, and are there handrails available? Electrical outlets covered, especially from the toddlers, you know, with this cover piece. Grab bars in the bathroom, sturdy shower chairs, tub bench, and again, good furniture, lighting. Guns are all locked up, you know, locked in a cabinet, shelves removed. And throw rugs. Are these items off? Because a lot of times they will cause some problems. I need to step off camera just a moment and to check my time here. Okay, I've got 5 minutes left, so I didn't bring my egg timer home. So, now, tips for oxygen handling, of course, no smoking around. Make sure you've got your signs on the outside of the house so any visitors coming to visit the person knows that they need to get the cigarette out before they come out. A lot of times, like you can see in the background here, maybe even myself, I've got the oxygen tanks here. I've got a concentrator at home, but I've got backup oxygen tanks. Now, they're kind of stored upright, not real safe. They're just leaning. Technically, I should have them in a more secure place, but I wanted to kind of talk about this here. And you've seen them several times behind me there. They need oxygen. Tanks need to be stored upright in each individual holding device, holding them well. You know, don't allow your oxygen equipment to get near, you know, heat, flammable, grease, oil, things like that. Make sure they're working well. Turn off your oxygen tanks for your folks. Teach them to turn them off. They're not using them. Now, if you've got folks with dementia, you know, in the home, make sure there are locks on the inside doors so at night if the caregiver is sleeping, they can't get out. You might even want to lower the temperature or get somebody to lower the temperature on the hot water heater, maybe down to 100, 105, so that they could not accidentally burn themselves. Put safety knobs on the stoves, safety locks on cabinets and drawers, especially those drawers with medicine in it, or knives in it, or cabinets with medicine in them. Keep a night light on several, you know, see if you can get the family to get night lights at several different rooms in the house so that they will be lighted, they walk around. Help the family, teach the family, or monitor this, that they have an ID bracelet on the resident, the client with Alzheimer's, so if they do get out, you know, they can be identified. Locks on the bathroom door, probably best to remove them. So if the client does go in to the bathroom, they won't lock themselves in. Keep furniture in the same places. Don't be moving it around a lot, because the folks with Alzheimer's remember. They kind of tend to memorize where things are at. So you don't want to be moving stuff around too much on them. And then live plants, artificial plants, you know, if they start picking at them, chewing at them, eating them, you know, you would need to get them out. So be alert, be observant, trust your instincts, and of course know when and how to dial 911. And, you know, safety when walking, monitor that. And of course your own safety when you're driving yourself from place to place, keep your own safety in mind, especially in hot summer days and in icy, snowy days in the winter. Follow your facility procedure for these weather issues that, especially like we're having this summer, you know, 105 days in Kansas here. So be mindful of that for your own safety. Okay, this was video number 21, and this is where we're going to stop right now. Thank you.